Here is a typical Foley catheter management system. I don't even think it's Medline's, but to me it didn't matter because they all really looked the same. And Medline challenged us to really develop a new approach to managing catheters because they had heard that there were problems at the time of doing it with maintaining the sterile field, and of course the biggest problem is the UTIs. So we started to really look at the catheters and take it apart, and the first thing that I noticed was that it has these two trays to it, and it's fussy and the catheter flails about and you have to sort of get in there and make it all organized. So we thought of ways that we could rethink the experience to apply the Foley catheter. And I brought them a whole bunch of ideas, different ideas for trays, different ideas for labeling the information to try and bring clarity. And we all sort of gravitated towards this one-layer tray solution, which we felt would help maintain the sterile field and help keep things organized. So we started to develop the one-layer tray, and this is what we ended up with. We developed the tray to design the hands and the minds of the people that are actually using the Foley catheter and applying it. You'll see that we have labeling of each step so that it is intuitive and leads you from one step to the next. We have sterile water, lubricating jelly, Foley catheter and drainage bag, swab stick and specimen container. And then the other products are sequenced in the order that you would need them and wrapped up that come in the bag. For example, we have hand sanitizer right in the correct place for when you would need it. Although, we still have that? Yeah, okay. So it comes undone, and then you have all the things that you need in the order that you need it. We designed a labeling system that was a trifold, and we had on the front cover a picture of what was inside, and you would open it up, and you would have step-by-step instructions with clear tips on what not to do or what to do to try to avoid the incident of cauti. The instructions were very clear and the tips. And then that last page you would tear off and you would give to the patient at the bedside so that they knew what was going on, and it was some patient education. So as Sue had mentioned earlier, we were very excited about this, and it was in, it came in a clear bag, and we thought that it would be great, and so we wanted to test it. So that's when we started working with Dr. Haywood and his team and the VHA, and they started to develop, they started to go in and do research on this project, and I think they went to one hospital, two hospitals, and started to do the study. And we got a lot of learning from that, and that's why I keep going back to this idea of collaboration, because we thought we were going in the right direction, but if it wasn't for these studies and these insights that we learned, we would have ended up with a product that is not as advanced as what we have now. And I could spend an entire session on talking about collaboration with manufacturers and clinicians and hospital executives and social observers, designers, and many others, because we just all learn from each other, and it's an endless battle of trying to make sure that keeping these lines of communication stay open. And in this situation, we learned so much from social observations at the on the field. So the two biggest things, and I'll let Trent explain it later, more of it later, but the two biggest things that we learned was, for example, the patient insert was in the bag, and even though we had a line drawing of the contents inside, it really got overlooked and ended up in the trash can anyway. And that, I think, was for two reasons. One, because no one really bothered with it. They didn't really see it that well. And two, because no one wanted to read how to apply a Foley catheter in front of their patient. So that was a big learning right there. So no one really wanted to take the time to do that. And time, of course, was an issue. We also had the patient education card that was part of this, which I think also got overlooked because they didn't want to take the time, because it ended up in the trash. So here we thought we had something quite clever, and it turned out that it ended up in the trash can. So we're very grateful for those insights that we were able to learn about. Once we all convened and learned about this, we redesigned it again, and we ended up taking the, instead of line drawings, we ended up taking the actual picture of the tray and put it on a sticker right on top of the package. This way, if people need to see it right away, they can. If they need to open it, they can. And they don't have to make the whole experience unsterile, and they can keep it in the storage closet if they need to and go back to it. So that was a really great advancement. Another thing is the stop and check at the bottom, which we always had, but now we incorporated all at the same place. And I wish that Dr. Gawanda was here to see this, because I wonder what his comments would be on it. But we have a stop and check list on the actual package at when you take it, at the moment that you're about to open it, to make sure that you have a valid indication, to make sure that this is necessary, to make sure that you are doing all the right things. So it's a pause. And then you can open up the label and get step-by-step instructions and tips. And now, instead of the patient education card being part of the label, we decided to make it much more of a warmth and encouraging connection that the nurse can have with the patient. So we decided to make it, more of a Hallmark type of a card, where you would have this wonderful warm card that you can actually feel proud, feel happy to give to the patient. And it's a real moment where the nurse or practitioner can connect and educate the patient and their families. And it can stay out and it can just look nice. We had an illustrator do it who is very well known, so it was a great improvement there. And it comes in every single package, and it's sequenced at the right point. Another thing that we're doing is now we came out with a pediatric CAUTI kit. After we've launched the CAUTI kit, now we have the pediatric one. And we decided to develop our own little character called Buddy the Brave. So that's a Medline character. And instead of having your typical label, we have a pediatric one, which I think that is easily identifiable and also will help connect and get you into the zone of being with a pediatric patient. Instead of a patient care card, we have an activity card, which is filled with all sorts of activities plus education for the family and caregivers.